Hey everyone, this is Jody from Joderson Art coming to you from Phoenix, Arizona on a nice rainy day, which never happens here. This is a painting I did about a week ago and I tried something new. As you can see, there's lots of sparkles in there, so that always makes me happy. As a girl, I'm partial to sparkly things. I was playing around with the Sherwin-Williams Color To Go paints. I actually stopped into the Sherwin-Williams store and they were on sale. They're normally like $7.50 and they had a 25% sale off. So I picked about 10 and decided to start playing with them. So since they're expensive, I'm working on a smaller canvas than normal. This is a 8x8 round. And these are the Sherwin-Williams colors that I'm using. The purple, the deep purple color that I'm using is actually kimono violet. The blue color that I'm using is fountain, and the last color that I'm using is dragon fruit. So you can basically go in there, pick any color off the wall, and they'll make it for you. So I decided to try this because I wanted to see how my pigments held up on top of this particular paint, and to see if some of these colors showed through and if they actually made cells as well. So I had no idea how this was going to turn out, and it was just an experiment. Always trying to try something new. So I just laid these out in stripes, and now I'm just kind of marrying it together. And I decided to put my swipe paints across the painting instead of up and down. So the first pigment I'm using is actually Sapphire by the Fluid Art Company. And the next color I'm using is Passion by Color Art. The next color I'm using is the Boom Gel Stain Pearlescent Teal. This color is another little piggy from the Fluid Art Company. This is called Nightfall. This is Vavoom Red by Color Art. I had a little paint left over, so I just thought I'd throw on there. And last, this is the Interference Gold, the Bling It by Color Art as well. And you'll see how that little bit of paint is gonna add so much to this painting at the end. So I'm gonna start my swiping. I just swipe with regular cardboard. This was actually some of the packaging that came with the canvas. And I just cut it up into little squares. And I usually only use it for two or three times before I either turn it over and use the other side or throw it away because I find it gets too bendy. My cell activator that I'm using today is Australian Floetrol and Golden Heavy Body Black Carbon. And the ratio is 4:1. All of my paints and pouring medium is always listed in my description. And I'm always available for questions if you guys have any. If you leave it, I get a notification and I try to answer everyone. So if you take a look on the right hand side, you can already see how that interference gold, just a little bit, is adding a lot of sheen to the painting already. So we're just gonna go around and finish swiping up. And I'm really liking the way that the paint is sitting on top of the Sherwin-Williams Color To Go, and it's not dragging. I find sometimes I use Color Place by Walmart, I find that sometimes when I'm swiping that the paint and the pillow paint drag, so even when I'm keeping a constant pressure on it. So I'm liking the way this is kind of floating, and if you can see, the colors from the Colors To Go are actually producing cells as well. So that's fun, something else I learned today. So the next thing that I'm going to do is, see that black line in the middle? Well, I don't really like it. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spin this out and open up the cells a little bit more. As you can see, the struggle bus picked me up here. Again, it picks me up almost every day. And I'm trying to spin it, the painting's moving around, the paper's getting tucked under the spinner. I usually use the puppy pull and another spinner, but this is my table one. So yeah, I'm struggling a little bit here. But thank God the painting didn't fly off, because that's happened before as well. And we're just opening up those cells a little bit. So there's some really pretty colors in here. Some of it is from the Color To Go, and the other one's my pigments. Now with that black line that I was talking about a few minutes ago, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to make it disappear. So I'm gonna do some really light balloon kisses here. And I'm not doing smashes, I'm not smashing it in there. I'm just trying to get that line to disappear and marry those paints together because I don't like the separation. So I am not great at balloon kisses. Julie Cutts does some amazing balloon kisses, but not me. My roots are in acrylic pouring, and this was one of the first techniques I learned how to do, but obviously I never mastered it. So I'm okay with that. We're just going to kind of turn the colors around from both sides and get them to come together. And when you're doing this, just a little turn in it gives it like this little curly cue in there, which it's kind of cute. And it really helps the painting become more fluid. So I'm almost done here. And make sure you wipe that paint off your balloon. So just one or two more. And the last one. So as you can see, that black line disappeared, and that's exactly what I was looking to do. So I'm going to pick this up and try to bring it in a little closer for you guys to show you. And as you can see, we have some really nice lacing. The cells held together well. And that interference gold really came through on this, really made everything pop. So one of my favorites. So I hope you guys liked my video today. You know, this is a learning community for me. And if we can teach each other anything, then, you know, every painting's a win. So thanks for watching my video. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. And like I said, I'm always available for questions. Thanks so much, guys. Fucked it, friend, it's someone said, it stuck the